Welcome all of you to my channel ePhysics for you. Many of us don't understand exactly what is voltage source and why internal resistance is applied to the series. Today I will give you a clear idea about this. I hope today's video will be very important and helpful. Before we start this topic, we'll try to know first what is source. A source is a device which converts mechanical, chemical, thermal or some other form of energy into electrical energy. But in electrodynamics, we refer to the sources as the active element which generates electrical energy and supplies it to the electrical circuit, such as battery, generator, operational amplifier, etc. We will now discuss how many type of sources there are in electrical network. Here we have two type of sources in the electrical network. One of them is voltage source and other is current source. A voltage source has a forcing function of EMF, whereas the current source has a forcing function of current. I want to say in comment, how many of you know the full form of EMF and MMF? The current and voltage source are further categorized as an ideal source and practical source. Now, in this video, we only discuss about voltage sources. We have already seen that voltage sources have been divided into two categories. The first is ideal voltage source and other is practical voltage source. First, we will see what is ideal voltage source. A voltage source is a two-terminal device whose voltage at any instant of time is constant, and no matter what amount of current is drawn from it, that is, terminal voltage is independent from the load resistance. This is the important point: no matter what amount of current is drawn from it. Such a voltage source is called an ideal voltage source and it contains zero internal resistance. This is the symbolic representation of the ideal and practical voltage source. This is the circuit diagram of an ideal voltage source. From this circuit, we will get the voltage drop across the load AB by applying Kirchhoff's voltage law. V of AB equals to IL into RL, or we can write also it VS equals to IL into RL. By combining these two equations, we will get V of AB equals to V of S. This figure shows the circuit diagram and the VI characteristics of an ideal voltage source. This graph shows that if we increase current to the circuit, voltage drop across the load must be constant as V of AB equals to V of S. But practically it is not possible, because in reality any voltage source must be contain some internal resistance. It is the inherent property of any sources. It is possible only mathematically. Now we will discuss about practical voltage source. Sources having some amount of internal resistance are known as practical voltage source. Due to this internal resistance, voltage drop takes place. And for these reasons, voltage across the load will no longer be constant. It will change with current. This is the circuit diagram of a practical voltage source. By applying KVL law, the voltage drop across the terminal AB will be V of AB equals to V of L equals to V of S minus IL into RS, where IL represent load current and RS represent internal resistance. We can also write it VL equals to IL into RL. We can write by combining these two equations IL RL equals to VS minus IL into RS, and we can write it IL equals to VS by RS plus RL. This equation says that if we vary RL, then IL also vary. VL will change for this changing IL as VL also correlated with each other. For this reason, terminal voltage across AB will not have constant. Here a question comes to our mind that why internal resistance of practical voltage source is connected in series but not in parallel. I will give you this answer after a while. This figure shows the circuit diagram and VI characteristics of a practical voltage source, where terminal voltage varies with load current. Here, dotted line indicates the ideal voltage source and solid line indicates the practical voltage source, which deviates from ideal voltage source. The gap between two arrows indicate the internal voltage drop of practical voltage source. Which one of these two circuits is allowed or not allowed? Before watching this answer in my video, pause this video and try to find out this answer, and I am sure that you will get this answer. The first circuit will not be allowed because two 10 volt batteries are connected in parallel. We know that the voltage will be same in parallel connection, so it will provide only 10 volts across AB terminals. So this circuit will not be beneficial to us. The second circuit will be allowed because 10 volts and 5 volt batteries are connected in series. We know that voltages are added in series, so it will provide 10 plus 5, that is 15 volts across AB terminals. So this circuit will be beneficial to us. Now I will give you the answer to the previous question. The internal resistance representation signifies the non-idealization of the source. What problems would we face if it were parallel? We know that parallel voltages are the same, and also it would just short the battery. To avoid this situation, a high internal resistance had to be applied in parallel. And since the resistance was always applied to the parallel with the battery, and even if the load resistance was not applied, it would always go through the current. As a result, the battery would be damaged quickly. By applying the internal resistance in series, we have made it as small as possible, so that the voltage drop across it is minimum, and thus the maximum voltage drop across the load is ensured. It can be understood by drawing Thevenin's equivalent circuit. Hope you understand.